So, good morning all of you. Welcome to Physics Online session. In the previous class, we have discussed refraction at a spherical surface where we have derived a formula for curved surface, that is N2 by image distance minus N1 by object distance is equals to N2 minus N1 by R. Okay. So now in this class, we'll discuss refraction by a lens, and we are also derive formula for lens and lens makers formula. First, we need to know what is a lens and what are the different types of lenses available in optics. What is a lens? So lens is a transparent optical medium bounded by two surfaces, out of which either one or two may be curved. Okay, so this is a transparent medium. This is a glass, nothing but transparent medium. So it is enclosed or bounded by two surfaces. So this is one refraction surface. This is another refraction surface where the refraction takes place. Why? Because these boundaries are separating two media, air and water, like. Okay, so this is about the lens. And generally, there are two types of lenses in optics: convex lens, convex and concave lenses. Okay, so this is the biconvex lens and this is a biconcave lens. Why? Because the two refracting surfaces are bulged outward, then it is said to be a convex lens, and it is known as converging lens. So why? Because light rays after passing through this convex lens or biconvex lens, they converges. So they converges. So it is known as converging lens. The biconcave lens. So the two surfaces are curved inward, and light rays after passing through this appear through this lens appears to diverge from this lens. So it is known as diverging lens. Okay. And the next discuss the different types of lenses, different types of convex and concave lenses. Already we have discussed what is a biconvex lens. Two surfaces are bulged outward, so biconvex lens. If one of the surfaces is plane and other is concave, then plane or concave lens. If one of the surfaces is concave, convex, and other is concave, concave or convex, or convex or concave. So, and the third type of and the types of concave lenses: biconcave. Two surfaces are curved inward, so biconcave. One of the surfaces convex and other is concave, convex or concave, and it is plane or concave. These are the different types of lenses available in optics. Okay, so where we use this convex lens? Convex lens are used in spectacles, okay, magnifying lenses, etc. And these are the different types of lenses are used in camera lenses, in optical instruments like microscope, telescope, these lenses and their combinations, proper combination is used, okay, to view smaller objects and distant objects. Okay, so this is about the different types of lenses. And what about the ray diagrams? Actually, I represented ray diagrams for concave lens. The rules for rules for drawing ray diagrams, actually these are the rules for drawing ray diagrams. So I represent you only for concave lens here. I'll draw the ray diagrams for convex lens also. For example, so if the light ray is parallel to the principal axis, after the refraction what happens? It come to focus at a point on the principal axis. Okay, whatever the position of this parallel ray of light, okay, if it is parallel, definitely it comes to focus at a point on the principal axis, that is focus. Okay, this is the first rule. And if the ray of light is directed towards optic center, it does not deviate from its actual path. Okay, it goes straight, okay, without bending. And third rule is, the ray of light is directed towards a focus, it becomes parallel to the principal axis. Before that, we need to represent some points regarding lens. So this is the midpoint of the convex lens or midpoint of the concave lens. So the midpoint is nothing but the optic center. This is the optic center. Optic center, and you know this is the principal axis, and there are two pair of points on either side of this lens. This is the first refracting surface, second refracting surface. So we have two focus. So either you can write F1 and F2 and two centers of curvature C1 and C2. Similarly for concave lens also, we have two pair of points, two centers of curvature, two focus 4C and two radii of curvature and two focal lens. For a lens, we have two pair of points. Okay. Now, look at the second. Look at this picture. No. When object is on the left side, the parallel ray of light represent the object is at a infinite distance. When object is at infinity, we will get the image at the focus. And just remember how to draw ray diagrams. Okay. Next, for concave lens, same figure. So a parallel ray of light after passing through this concave lens appears to be coming from focus, not directly meet the focus. And second ray diagram, a ray of light which is directed towards a focus become parallel to the principal axis. When a ray of light passes through the optic center, it does not deviate from its actual path. Try to remember these figures. Okay, the rules for drawing ray diagrams. From those rules, some ray diagrams are drawn here. So these are the ray diagrams. Actually, this is for convex lens. Ray diagrams for convex lens. So when object is at infinity, the light rays which are coming from the object which is at infinity, the light rays almost parallel. The parallel beam of light after passing this convex lens will meet at a point on the principal axis, that is the focus. Okay, and you know these rules. When object is placed behind the center of curvature, you will get the image in between F and G. When object is at the center of curvature, we will get the image on the same center of curvature but on the other side. Okay. So, and when object is in between center and focus, we will get the image beyond center of curvature. When object is at focus, image will be at infinity. When object in between focus and optic center, the image will be absorbed on the same side. These are the some rules. I'll try to remember. Now I'm going to actual topic, today's topic, that is refraction by a lens. Okay, so here I'll draw. I'm taking a convex lens here. So this is a biconvex lens. Okay, this is a convex lens, and this is the principal axis of this lens, convex lens. Okay, now I'm taking a biconvex lens of refractive index n2, which is placed in the medium of refractive index n1. So outside medium is, let us assume it is air, and it is a glass. Convex lens, nothing but a glass medium. Okay, let r1 comma r2 be the radii of curvatures of this lens, radius of curvatures. Okay, why? Because it has two curved surfaces, so that is why it has two radii of curvature, two centers of curvature and two 4C focal lens. Okay, now let us place an object on the principal axis. Okay, now we are discussing the image formation by a lens, particularly convex lens. So I need to place an object. I am placing a point object. Is a point object placed on the principal axis. So, and this is a optic center. This is an optic center. So here I am, from this object I am taking two light rays from this object. One is parallel to the principal axis. One is parallel to the principal axis. And other is other is going to strike the lens first refracting surface at this position. Okay, so since it is traveling from rarer to denser medium, it bends towards the normal and one refraction takes place, so it bends and moves like this. Okay, so here the first refraction of light takes place. Okay, let it be the first refracting surface. There the bending of light takes place. Okay, so at the second refracting surface, one more bending takes place and finally reaches the principal axis at this position, where we will get the final image I. Okay, let us assume there is no second refracting surface. If there is no second refracting surface, what would be the path? It would travel in a straight line and come to focus at this position. Okay, so this is the image due to first refracting surface. This is the image due to both the refracting surfaces. So here I'll represent the distances here. Object distance is u, so and this distance I'll call it as v, and the total distance I'll call it as v dash. Okay, so all the distances should be measured from this optic center. Okay, tro, sometimes we represent with t also. So this is the figure. Okay, now I'm taking the second, I want to represent second light ray here. This is second light ray. So the light rays, after passing through the lens, so they are meeting at a point, so they will get the final image. This is the image. Okay. Now, in order to derive lens formula, I'll use formula for curved surface. What is the formula for curved surface? What is the formula for curved surface? So in the last class, we have derived that N2 by V minus N1 by U is equals to N2 minus N1 by R. This is a formula for curved surface. Let us take it equation number 1. Now I'll apply the same formula to first and second surfaces separately. For the first surface, apply this formula for curved surface. First refracting surface. This is the first refracting surface and the second refracting surface. Now, for the first refracting surface, the first object image distance is v. What is the image distance? V dash. Okay, if we have only first refracting surface, where would be the image? So we'll get the image here. So v1 is the image due to first refracting surface. Now I'm talking only first refracting surface. So for the first refracting surface, we can write this formula as, what is the second medium, the refractive index of second medium as it is, as it travels from N1 medium of rarer medium of refractive index N1 to denser medium of refractive index N2, the second medium having refractive index N2, first medium refractive index N1. So we can write this formula as N2 by what is the image distance due to first refracting surface? It is V dash minus the first medium refractive index by the object distance is U is equals to N2 minus N1 by R1. Okay, so this R1 is a radius of curvature for the first refracting surface. And further, I let it be equation number 2. Equation number 2. For the second refracting surface, second refracting surface. So we need to write the same formula here for the second refracting surface. Here light is traveling from denser medium to rarer medium. What is the second medium for this second refracted ray? N1 is the second medium, N2 is the first medium, and image distance is V, and object distance is not U, object distance is V. So for the second refracting surface, the image of the first refracting surface acts as an object to the second refracting surface. This is not the real image, this is a virtual image. So we can write the formula as N. What is the second medium refractive index? N1. By what is the final image distance? V. Minus what is the refractive index of first medium for the second refracted ray? N1. Sorry, not N1, N2. By image distance, what is object distance? V dash. That is equals to refractive index of second medium minus refractive index of first medium by R2. Why? Because why N1? N1 is nothing but the refractive index of second medium, this second medium, why it is traveling from denser to rarer. No, N1 acts as second medium, N2 acts as a first medium. Please remember, so here V dash is the object, will act as a V1, V dash will act as a object to the second refracting surface. Okay, right. So please remember, the image due to first refracting surface will act as a object to the second refracting surface. By using that concept, I wrote this expression. And let it be equation number 3. Now adding equations, two and three, or add equations 2 and 3. By adding equations 2 and 3, we get. What do you get? So here, when you add these two equations, here N2 by V dash plus N2 by V dash. So minus N2 by V dash, these two terms cancel out, and finally we will get N1 by V minus N1 by U is equals to, so we'll get, I'll write the detailed expression so that you can understand easily. So what is the LHS of this one? N2 by V dash minus N1 by U plus N1 by V minus N2 by V dash is equals to N2 minus N1 by R1 plus N1 minus N2 by R2. Okay, so next that implies, now these two will cancel, N2 by V dash, N2 by V dash cancel out. We can take N1 common from this expression. When you take N1 common from this expression, what do you get? 1 by V minus 1 by U is equals to, I want to take N2 minus N1 common from this expression. When you take N2 minus N1 common from this expression, we'll get first term as 1 by R1 plus 1 by, not plus here, when you, here we have N1 minus N2 term, but we are taking N2 minus N1 common. So we'll get negative sign 1 by R1 minus 1 by R2. So when you simplify it, you will get 1 by V minus 1 by U is equals to N2 by N2 minus N1 by N1. So into 1 by R1 minus 1 by R2. Okay. And the next one, 1 by V minus 1 by U is equals to N2 by N1 minus 1 into 1 by R1 minus 1 by R2. Okay. So, and we'll get finally 1 by v minus 1 by u, finally we can write it as n2 by n1, we can write it as n21 minus 1 into 1 by r1 minus 1 by r2. Okay, let it be another equation, let it be equation number 4. Next, so no, I'm using one condition here. So let us suppose when object is at infinity. So u is equals to infinity. Okay. And where do you get the image? Then the image will be obtained. Image will be focus. Okay. So v is equals to infinity. Yes or no? So already we have discussed in the ray diagrams when object is at look at this picture. When object is at infinity, where you get the image? So we'll get the focus. That is why I'm using that condition here to derive formula for curved formula for lens maker's formula. Okay. Now I want to substitute these values u equals to infinity and v equals to 1 by I wrote wrong here. V is equals to f. And after substituting these values in this above expression, we'll get 1 by f, 1 by infinity, 1 by infinity becomes 0. So we'll get n to 1 minus 1 into 1 by r1 minus 1 by r2. Okay. In the next step, we'll write 1 by f is equals to 1 by f equals to n to 1 minus 1, I'll remove this expression. Not clear. Okay. Next, that is equals to n to 1 minus 1 into 1 by r1 minus 1 by r2. Okay. So let it be equation number 5. Okay. This equation is called as Lensmaker's formula. This is Lensmaker's formula. Okay. So now I'll compare the equations 4 and 5. Now I want to compare equations 4 and 5. So when you compare equations 4 and 5, what do you get? So why we need to compare here? Why? Because RHS of these two equations is same. So when you compare LHS, what do you get? 1 by V minus 1 by U equals to 1 by F. Okay. So, okay. By comparing equations of 4 and 5, equations 4 and 5, we get 1 by f is equals to 1 by v minus 1 by u. Okay, so this is about the Lens formula. This is the Lens formula. Okay. Right. Now we have derived Lens formula in this class. Now, what is the magnification of a lens? What is the magnification of a lens? So what is mean by magnification? It is a ratio of height of image to height of object is equals to height of object, or the ratio of image distance to object distance. So for convex lens, you will get V by U is a magnification. For lens, for a concave mirror, regard this expression of magnification as H dash by H is equals to minus V by U. Why? Because for the concave mirror, all the distance are negative, image distance also, we got a negative expression in that equation. But here, the distances, image distance is measured positive here. Why? Because here, look at the object distance. So light reached towards the right and object distance is measured from optic center to object, measured opposite to the direction of incident light. So object distance is taken as negative. So object distance for convex lens is taken as negative. Image distance is taken as positive. Why? Because we are measuring from pole to image. We are moving the direction of light. So image distance, sorry. Why I'm writing infinity? Okay. Yeah, image distance is taken as positive. Object distance is taken as, sorry, image distance is taken as positive and object distance is taken as negative. R1 is taken as positive and R2 is taken as negative. Okay. So F1 is positive and F2 is negative. Okay, this is the first refracting surface, R1. So, for the first refracting surface, so R1 is measured from the pole to a center of curvature, measured in the direction of light. So, R1 is positive, R2 is negative, F1 is positive, F2 is negative. Okay, for concave lens, so these are different. Okay, so here, we'll discuss it later. Okay, no, I'll stop.